The technology is very powerful. The people ruling the world have very powerful and visible technology. I would say the number one thing, the number one obstacle we face that we have not figured out how to defeat is mind control.
Our group, working with others internationally, inclusive of the Nuffield Council in the UK, proceeded forward from 2008 and did a slightly deeper dive, looking at international capabilities, limitations and delimitations in the brain sciences, and came to a very, very different set of conclusions. Not only were the brain sciences increasingly being considered, interested, and used for possibilities of national security, intelligence, and defense, but they would continue to be so as more and more countries internationally developed the capabilities and the specialized agendas to be able to look into the brain and affect the brain. So much so that by 2014, the exact same committee reconvened and recognized at that time that the brain sciences indeed were ready and in operational prime time for warfare, intelligence, and national security agenda. In other words, it is valid, valuable, and already in operational play. Do you see how this can work? Furthermore, I can use this very tactically. Some of these agents allow me to assemble the agent on site and not have to stockpile it, which allows me to take the components of this agent into and out of a country, relatively covertly, target a specific individual, change or eliminate that individual with very little attribution and trace, and be able to leave prior to any attribution. Think Novichok. Or I could assemble very small quantities of this that would then allow a specific intervention, characteristically in a place that would not allow such an intervention. Think of the use of a derivative of VX in an airport. But I could do more than that. I could also incur a much broader type of ripple effects. One of the ways I could also do that is with what's called high morbidity neuromicrobiologic agents. It's a real fancy way of saying neurobugs. But high morbidity neurobugs. I may not want to kill a lot of people. In fact, arguably, I may assume what is sometimes referred to as the Sailor Malin mantra. For those of you who may be fans or students of military history, you may remember that Sailor Malin, Wing Commander Sailor Malin, was a South African who flew with the Royal Air Force during the Second World War. And he became